All right, so slicers are finally here, so let's take a look at them and see what we can do with this. To use a slicer, let's start by building a pivot table from this data set. So if I quickly just take a look here, if I do control down or command down, see we have 1400 lines. So we're gonna do a quick pivot table out of this, going under data. I'm gonna do a pivot table. I'm gonna put it on a new worksheet. That's fine. To make sure this pivot table updates going forward, I will just unselect this, and as a data range, I'm gonna select the entire column going down. I'm gonna hit OK and create again. So to build the pivot table, I'm gonna go under values here. I'm gonna add sales as values, and I'll go under rows and do sales reps as rows. And to get rid of these blanks, because we selected the whole column, I'm gonna scroll down here and under filters do sales rep. And as a filter, I will filter by condition. And instead of none, I will select is not empty. Hit OK. That should take care of that. So in pivot tables, we have these filters. We can use this to add more filters. So for example, if I wanted to filter this by region, just add another basically filter by region, and now we have a region. So I can go here and just clear this and do Midwestern, hit OK. That should filter to just that. Then you can just go here and change this. But this is not very visually pleasing for somebody who doesn't understand how to use these things. So to make something more user-friendly, I'm gonna take this back and remove this. We're gonna add a slicer to this pivot. So what we do, we just click on this pivot table, go under data, and click slicer. And that's gonna show the list of columns from our data set. Again, I'm gonna go ahead and choose region. So we want to make sure this apply to pivot tables is checked. Then I can take this and move this around. And now we have this. So if I take this and do Midwestern, you'll see that should filter the pivot table. So it's mostly basically just a nicer looking filter for this pivot table. What's really great about this is that I can actually add more pivot tables using the same data on the same worksheet here, this pivot table 13 worksheet, and I'm just gonna call it report. And that same slicer should work for those as well. So let me go ahead and add that second pivot table here. I'm gonna go back to the subtotal tab, again, select all of the columns, data, and pivot table. And now I'm gonna do existing worksheet, click in this, go back to my report tab, and here basically click where I want that second pivot table to show up. I'll just click over here, that's fine. Hit OK and hit create. So here we'll do number of sales by brand. So I'm gonna go brand here and values, we'll do sales. Since I don't want the sum, I'm gonna do count. So let me just scroll right so you can see what's going on here. So we have this. And here I want to get rid of these blanks again. So I'm gonna add a filter for brand column and filter by condition and is not empty to get rid of that blank on top. Good. Scroll this way, close this. So now we have two pivot tables here. And if I go here and filter to a particular region, we should have both of them filtered to that region. So if I do Midwestern, that should again just filter both of them, and it works. This will work on pivot tables. This will also work on charts, but you have to make sure that all the pivot tables and all the charts are made using the same range of data. If you have different data sets, it will not work. You also want to make sure that all those pivot tables and charts appear on the same worksheet. Otherwise, again, it's not gonna work. So let me go ahead and add a little chart here. So to do a chart out of this, I'm just gonna do a pie chart by gender. I'll select all of this, go under insert and chart. There it is. So instead of column chart, I'm gonna switch this to a pie chart. We're going to change this to the label being gender. So I'll click in here and select that column in the background. This is that E column, gender, hit OK. So we want to make sure we aggregate values, but the values we aggregate is not going to be date, it's going to be sales. So I'll just edit this and change this to this H column and hit OK. And then I'm going to check this aggregate because I want the total of that column broken down by gender. So there it is. We have ourselves a pie chart. You can obviously make it pretty and things like that. I'm not going to worry about it right now. So I'll go ahead and cut this chart because this needs to be here on this tab. So I'll do Command X or Control X if you're on Windows. And then I'm going to go here and do Command V or Control V to bring that chart over and paste it here. We'll just resize this, fit this in here somehow. There it is. Now it's on the same worksheet as this other stuff. So let's go ahead and select all. There it is, our numbers change. We go ahead and select Midwestern. Everything changes. So our charts and our pivot tables using the same data are all updating based on that slicer. You can also add multiple slicers if you want to. So if I click on one of these pivot tables, go under data and click slicer, it will get us another slicer. We'll choose another column we want to filter this by. So let's say I want this to be state or gender. It doesn't really matter. I'll do gender, that's fine. And now we have two slicers here side by side and we can just use both of them to filter stuff. So if I go here and do female, it will just filter these. And now we have 100% female here because we filtered the rest. And these two filter, and then you can also filter by this one, Midwestern. So I'm going to take this clear, select all, hit OK, get back to this. So what if we want to add a date slicer? So it's not going to be that different. We're going to click here and data slicer, yet another one, drag this someplace in here and choose a column date. And now we can filter this by dates and you have all these individual dates, which I don't think you're going to use. So we can go filter by condition and go here and scroll down and do things like date is before, date is after. If you have a specific range of dates you're trying to filter this to, you can also scroll down and find is between option. And then just give like the beginning date and the ending date. So I can do 2016-1 and I can do 12-31-2016. And then we're going to scroll down, hit OK. And that should just filter to that. But let's be honest, who wants to do this? Nobody wants to go here and try to enter this date somehow and hit OK. So most of the time, people just want to just have a dropdown that gives us years or months. But overall, this is how slicers work. Just make sure all your charts and your pivot tables are located on the same tab as your slicers and they all use the same data set and it's just gonna work. Now, let's take this to the next logical step and try to build a dashboard which will have nicer slicers that will give us years, months, this sort of stuff because, like I said, nobody wants to do this. So let's just get rid of all of this. And start from the beginning.